Don't you know everything lab now? If it ain't put it to rest, yo.
If he don't deserve it, blew a bag on it, cause he know I'm worth it. Maybelline cover girl for certain, and my body on point, they be like, who's your searching? Turns out, I'm never in the club. These niggas say I look better in person. I'm already getting used to the lurking.
Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision. Looking at one of the best heavyweights in UFC history, the man who holds the record still for the most consecutive heavyweight title defenses, the Cleveland-based firefighter Stipe Miocic, back for more time.
Going into our fight at UFC 226, he was universally considered the greatest heavyweight champion of all time, and that was rightfully deserved by beating Francis Ngannou, by beating Alistair Overeem, by beating Mauricio Verdun. When you beat guys like that, those honors are cast upon you, and you have deserved them. Stipe Miocic is one of the greatest fighters the heavyweight division has ever seen.
Well, this is about as decorated a kickboxer as has come into this division in some time, DC. And if we get a kickboxing match tonight, he ain't losing.
He is a championship-level kickboxer, a guy that can stand in the pocket and trade and kick and punch with anyone. He's constantly throwing things from as close as you can get. He's comfortable throwing leg kicks. He will drive these into your body. But it's the aggressiveness and the ability and willingness to stand in the pocket and trade that makes him truly, truly special. I think that is what separates kickboxers, the high level,
yeah,
from everyone else.
He understands distance as well as any striker in this division. Of course, that is a byproduct of a lifetime of repetitions in the kickboxing space. Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, and they both possess the same height and a similar reach. And now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the Octagon is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a wrestler holding a professional record of 20 wins, 4 losses. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 240 pounds, fighting out of Independence, Ohio, Stipe Miocic! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 11 wins, 1 loss. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 247 pounds. Fighting out of Paris, France, Cyril Bongamagan. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
You ready?
Here we go with round one. You are paid to tell us what you think is going to happen as an analyst. We have a striker, we have a grappler. Doesn't always play out that way, but what are you expecting to see in this one?
I'm expecting the grappler to try and go and make contact with his opponent.
Right.
If he can make contact, he can drag this fight to the mat. I expect the striker to try and maintain range with his jab, with his kicks, to make this a stand-up affair.
So both guys landing at will here. Good action early. Went for the inside leg kick. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Oh, man. I think you jumped out of your seat a little bit after that kick.
Oh, I did, because I have times where I've been kicked like that. And I'm going to tell you one thing. It does not feel good.
Oh, is that a big move? The body will see if he can follow up. Just over 3 minutes to go, round one.
Landed a good uppercut there.
Oh,
Oh, wow, those leg kicks are already taking effect. Look at how he turns his hip over when he shows that kick.
Back and forth we go. Huge right hand.
Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Whiffs on the straight right. Oh, how about that? He lands a huge kick. Some real power shots here. Oh, spinning back fist.
Boom. Big jab.
Man, is he timing. His opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He's hurt real bad. That punch landed in the perfect spot.
Less than a minute now to go in round one. Miocic gets caught with that punch. That's a good right hand there by Stipe. Maybe he'll attack the body here. You can certainly speak to that.
Yeah.
He's a guy who mixes it up well on the
back. He's a guy that can do everything. And not only can he land punches up high, punches up low, but he's a master of adjusting on the fly whenever he's inside the octagon.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh. What a fantastic
shot. Oh! Back to the feet. Oh!
Entertaining scrap so far.
Beautiful knockdown. Wow, that could have been a 10-8 round for you. But we want to finish. So moving forward, we know this.
All right, so there's the horn. Let us now look back at some of the action in that round, DC, and he had his takedown game going early and often.
Yeah, he had it going great. I mean, he did a great job of finding his entries, rushing to his finishes before his opponent could react and defend him. He should be very proud of the work he did over the course of that last round.
All right, round two.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! That one was heavy. Huge elbow there. Oh, he goes with the punch in the band.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Back to the feet. Nice kick there by Miocic. Put the guard beautifully there. Well, just exhausting watching some of these takedown attempts. He's unable to get it there.
And he's attempting it over and over again. How long before he gets discouraged and accepts that this is going to be a stand-up fight? Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Oh! He's out! Yeah, there's another one for the highlight reel, and that's probably as good a knockout as he's had in the UFC. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Crowd absolutely loving it. Flush land to close out his opponent. I'm not even sure the other fighters saw it coming. So a big knockout for him here tonight on the biggest of stages. Inside the octagon, Bruce Buffer with the official decision. Well, DC, you may want to retire before this guy becomes the number one heavyweight contender. Francis Ngannou, the power threat, born in Cameroon, raised in France, and has carved out quite a nice niche here thus far in the UFC.
Yes, he has. He's a very scary fighter. The knockout reel of Francis Ngannou is crazy, and the names now are starting to pile up. When you can knock out Alistair Overeem, Curtis Blaydes, and Cain Velasquez, people will take notice. It's just this confidence and this calmness about Francis that makes him even scarier than all of his physical attributes, is his ability to really stand in there and know that it only takes one shot and he could be wearing the UFC championship.
And UFC 218 was so good that that knockout of Alistair Overeem did not even earn Francis Ngannou a bonus.
Wow, that's insane.
Don't shoot the messenger.
I will shoot the messenger.
Don't shoot Ngannou. He'll come right through it. And now our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Ngannou is 4 years the elder. He will have a 5-inch reach advantage. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds of the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 12 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6'5" tall, weighing in at 252 pounds, Tom Aspinall! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 17 wins, 3 losses.
He stands 6'4" tall,
weighing in at 250 pounds.
Fighting out of Paris, France, Francis the Predator Ngannou! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
So Dan Mergliotta shares the cage.
You ready?
Expectations for this matchup as round one gets underway. It seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but on the other, truly a fighter who can do it all.
And that guy will usually have the advantage on paper. When you're a striker, at this guy's level, that will normally balance out whatever advantage the other guy has.
Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Ngannou gets absolutely punished by that head. Oh, big knee. Straight right. Kick to the body now. That one won't land.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Wow!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
And just inches away from with level change.
Oh, he went single. Rotate head outside. This dude's going for a ride.
Welcome to the Cormier Express. Going for the arm here.
Oh, wow. Oh!
He might get a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Goes upstairs for an elbow.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in.
And that will do it.
What a fight!
Yeah, that is high-level grappling right there as he gets the win tonight here by way of submission. And he bided his time there. He stayed patient, waited for an opening, and then when it was there, he certainly capitalized to get the tap here tonight. All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic. You are never safe when you're fighting this guy. You're in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble the entire time when you're this good in the submissions.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 27 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out, Tom Aspinall!
Well, What an incredible result here tonight, as you see the winner there celebrating his victory by way of submission. And they put so much stock into finishing this fight. They felt like to really spin his career forward, they needed to not just win but get the finish, and they certainly got it tonight.
They got the finish. He's such a terrific grappler. Every time he is on his back, he looks for submissions over and over again. Eventually, he found one tonight and got the desired result.